Hello everybody, welcome to jurycentral.com online classes for law exams. So today we are going to deal with you the solved previous year question paper of UPSC Deputy Legal Advisor exam 2011 for your upcoming UPSC CBI prosecutor exam, which is to be held in the year of 2021, the present one. So this is actually a practice set, so I am bringing this previous year question paper so that you could have the idea of what are the questions that could be asked and what are the questions that are anticipated for the present exam. These questions are all relevant for this CBI prosecutor exam, so do not think that these questions are irrelevant. And also, before starting this session, like always, I would request all of you to kindly like, share, subscribe to the channel so that you never miss such updates. We have already done the previous year question paper of 2017, 15 and 2010 as well. You would find the same in the I button which is attached over my image, and also you may check the playlist section of the channel to watch the practice papers which we have done previously. So let us start with our first question. So today we are going to deal with you a total number of 100 questions. Have patience, watch the video till the end, and if you have any doubts, query or any feedback, you may share the same in the comment section below. So let us start. Question number 1. A gas distributor insisted his customer to buy gas stove from him as a condition to give gas connection. It is held to be option number 1 and 3. This is unfair trade practices, there is a compulsion, and 3, unfair trade practices, the condition insists on purchasing something against the wishes of the customer. Question number 2, in the case of Mohiri Bibi versus Dharmadas Ghosh, the law that an agreement by a minor is void was settled by the Privy Council on the basis of section 11 and other related provisions of the Indian Contract Act 1872. Which principle of interpretation was applied by the Privy Council in this case? This option number, a literal rule. 3. X, a boy of 11 years, stabbed his father thrice as he saw that his two elder brother stabbed the father one after the other. He ran away. On being questioned, X justified his act, saying that his two elder brothers would not have stabbed the father unless he had done something wrong and hence deserved to be killed. What is the criminal liability of X in the case? So in this case, this is option number C. X should be acquitted as he had not attained sufficient maturity of understanding to judge the nature and consequences of his conduct. Question number 4. X took a big television from S and company on rent. The rent agreement provided that the company shall not be liable for any personal injury to the hirer or to any other person while using it. However, due to defect in the television, Y, his wife of X, was injured. Y brought an action against S and company. Which one of the following is correct? So the correct option is option number C. In this case, Y would succeed. 5. Which of the following statements regarding fundamental rights guaranteed in part 3 of the Constitution of India are correct? This option number A, 1 and 4. The reservation for women in the elected bodies is constitutionally permissible under Article 15, Clause 3 of the Constitution. And 4. Truth of a statement can be considered as a good defense in a contempt of a court case. Question number 6. The Supreme Court was confirmed with various issues relating to delegated legislation in the case of In Re Delhi Laws Act. This is the citation. Point out the incorrect statement with regard to this decision. This is option number A. Delegation of legislative power by the legislature to administrative organs was permissible. Question number 7. The liability for tort arises on option 2 and 3. Violation of right in personam and breach of a legal duty. Question number 8. Which of the following statements regarding powers granted under section 8 of the Arbitration and Cancellation Act 1996 are correct? So this option number 2 and 4. Section 8 is an instance of the least judicial intervention when there is an arbitration agreement between the parties. And 4. The application under section 8 shall not be entertained unless it is accompanied by the original arbitration agreement. So in the next session, I will be discussing with you the syllabus relevant for the UPSC CBI exams. This question is related to the Arbitration Act. So you may read the question or not, as per your choice. Question number 9. A witness may refresh his memory by referring to any writing made by this option of 1, 2 and 4. Option number 1, him at the time of the transaction. 2, may be made by him soon afterwards at the court, consider the transaction fresh in his memory. And 4, any other person present at the time of transaction. Question number 10. Which of the following are essential elements of the defense of fear committing the tort of defamation? These option number 2 and 3. An expression of opinion, and 3, of public interest. 11. Doctrine of desuetude refers to, so it refers to option number 2 and 3, state of disuse, and 3, contrary practice being adopted. Question number 12. A was suffering from typhoid and an insane delusion due to medication. B woke up at midnight and saw a tiger. C, his bedside. He took out a revolver and shot the tiger. When he woke up in the morning, he saw his 5-year-old daughter sleeping next to him in a pool of blood. A should be, this is option number C, acquitted, as he neither had the intention to kill his daughter nor the knowledge that his act was imminently dangerous, that it would in all probability cause her death. 13. Which one of the following is not the binding operative part of the conveyance? This is option number D, recital. 14. According to the provisions of which of the following, the untouchability is abolished and any person practicing untouchability is punishable? This is option 1, 2 and 4. The Protection of Civil Rights Act 1955. 2. The law made by Parliament by virtue of Article 35 of the Constitution of India. And 4. The law made by both the Parliament as well as state legislature by virtue of Article 17 of the Constitution of India. Question number 15. The Wednesbury principle doesn't stand for, so it doesn't stand for option number T, proportionality between the conduct and punishment. 16. A government contract not fulfilling the requirements of Articles 299 of the Constitution of India is actual option number D, unforeseeable by either of the parties. So this question, as you may see, these are actually a little tough in comparison to the question what we have dealt so far. So these questions are very unpredictable for the upcoming CBI exam. The questions may be of any type. So it is better that you prepare from the tough level and then you come to the medium level, because the questions will be moderate to hard. So this is the reason why I am presenting these questions to you. 17. An arbitral award may be set aside on proof that, again, this option number 1, 2 and 3, you may read the answer by yourself. 18. The Indian Evidence Act doesn't deal with option number D, rejection of evidence. 19. Which among the following are correct statements with regard to the nature of the CPC 1908, these option number 1 and 3, it is retrospective in its application, and 3, procedural with substantive part. 20. Which one among the following statute is usually retrospective in operation? These option number C, fiscal statutes. Question number 21. Section 110 of the CRPC doesn't apply in case of an offence committed under these option number D, Registration of Foreigners Act 1939. 22. Which one among the following is not a mechanism provided under Section 89 of the CPC 1908 as an alternative dispute resolution mechanism? This option number C, negotiation. 23. Which one of the following statements not correct? This option number C, the courts cannot issue a writ against the speaker from presiding over meetings of the house. Question number 24. A delegated legislation can be challenged in a court not only on all grounds on which the validity of a legislation can be challenged, but also on some more grounds. Point out the ground on which the validity of a legislation cannot be challenged. Option number D, non-compliance with the principles of natural justice. 25. Pawnee has a right to retain the goods pledged for this option number 1, 3 and 4, payment of the debt for which the goods were pledged. 3. Payment of subsequent debt if there is a contract to that effect, and 4. Interest on the debt and expenses for preservation of pledged goods. 26. The conciliation proceedings are terminated by this can be terminated by option number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Let us read, even if it is not important. Signing of settlement agreement by the parties to conciliator at his own, declaring in writing that further efforts are no longer justified. 3. Written declaration by the parties to the conciliator that conciliation proceedings are terminated. And 4. Written declaration by one party of the other party and conciliator that conciliation proceedings are terminated. Question number 27. The conduct of any party for the purpose of Section 8 of the Indian Evidence Act doesn't include statements So it doesn't include statements option number C unless they accompany and explain acts involved in those statements. 28. Which among the following is not an essential requirement for application of the principle of res judicata as per section 11 of the CPC 1908? This option number B, the subject matter ought to be the same. 29. In the case of Bengal Immunity Company versus State of Bihar, in order to cure problem of multiple taxation and preserve the free flow of interstate trade or commerce in the Union of India without any provincial barrier, the Supreme Court of India interpreted Article 286 of the Constitution of India with the help of which of the following rule of constitution? So this actual option number C, this is mischief rule. 30. In a summons case travelled by the magistrate, the investigation cannot be continued under section 167 clause 5 CRPC beyond a period of 6 months from the date of this option number C, starting of the investigation by the officer. Question number 31. Which one of the following it with respect to the law of pleadings and convincing is not correct? Again, this is not very much important, but let us read. The rules of pleading and convincing have no binding force, but in the case of the same are not followed, it shall amount to be bad instance of pleading and convincing. So this is not true. 32. The plaint under CPC shall not contain option number D, name of the judge in which the suit is instituted. 33. The director of prosecution under section 25A of the CPC shall function as option number C, administrative control of the head of the home department of the state. 34. Consider the following statements regarding the proclamation of national emergency under Article 352 of the Constitution of India. Correct option is option number C, 1, 2 and 4. A proclamation of emergency once approved by Parliament shall remain in force for a period of 6 months. 2. The satisfaction of the President under Article 352 is the satisfaction of the Union Council of Ministers. 4. The freedom given by the Article 19 of the Constitution can be suspended. 35. No tribunal can decide the validity of a rule legislation except one. Point out the tribunal which can decide that question. This is option number C, Administrative Tribunals under the Administrative Tribunals Act 1985. 36. In which one among the following cases a surety is not discharged? Option number C, contract between the creditor and a third person to give time to the principal debtor. 37. Conciliation proceedings under the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996 commence when? Option number B, the other party accepts the invitation to conciliate in writing. 38. Cross-examination of witness. This option number 2 and 3 need not be confined to the facts to which the witness testified on his examination chief. And 3, must relate to the facts in issue in that proceedings. 39. Which one of the following properties is transferable under the Transfer of Property Act 1882? This option number D, actionable claim. 40. A rule was laid down in Hayden's case which has now attained the status of a classic. The object of the rule is to option number D, suppress the mischief and advance the remedy. Question number 41. The fundamental rule of criminal jurisprudence regarding self-incrimination has been given constitutional status under Article 20 Clause 3 of the Constitution of India. It is actually option number 1, 2 and 4. A right to refuse brain mapping test to not a protection against giving specimen signature and thumb impression. And 4, a protection to a person against giving evidence against himself. 42. The mortgage where the mortgagor binds himself to repay the mortgage money on a certain date and transfers the mortgaged property absolutely to the mortgagee, but subject to a proviso that he will retransfer it to the mortgagor upon payment of the mortgagor money as agreed is called. So this kind of a mortgage is called English mortgage. 43. In respect of which of the following the decision in Maneka Gandhi versus Union of India makes a departure from earlier decision? These option 2 and 3. The hearing must be given before depriving a person of his personal liberty. 3. Article 14 cannot be invoked to challenge a law seeking personal liberty. Question number 44. When a contract has been broken and a sum is named in the contract as the amount to be paid in case of breach, the party complaining of the breach is entitled to this option number D, reasonable compensation not exceeding the sum stated. 45. When the award of an arbitrator cannot be somewhere in between and the arbitrator must choose one or the other of the other respective cases formulated by the parties, the arbitration is called, this is known as option number B, flip-flop arbitration. So these are the questions relating to English. So you may read the same by pausing the video. So this is a question which is based on para question number 52. And again, these are the questions relating to English, not relevant. This is the reason why I am not reading to you. Question, let's come to question number 56, assertion and reason based question. The fundamental rules of pleadings help in attaining the objective of giving fair notice to each party of what the opponent's case is and to ascertain with precision the point on which the parties agree and those on which they differ to. Neither conclusion of law nor provision of law can be challenged in the pleading. So this is actually option number A. Both the statements are individually true and statement 2 is the correct explanation of one. Question number 57, statement 1. While drafting, the material facts should be stated in a concise form, but the precision and certainty to achieve its actual object. 2. The drafting is necessarily divided into paragraphs numbered consecutively. Date, sums and numbers are given in figures as well as words in brevity. Again, the same. Both the statements are individual true and statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. 58. When the Indian Evidence Act declares one fact to be conclusive proof of another, the court. So in this case, the court, option number D, shall on proof of one fact regard the other as proved and shall not allow evidence to be given for the purpose of disproving it. 59. When the court is unable to assess damages, the aggrieved party may be awarded this option number A, nominal damages. 60. In which one of the following cases the offense of theft has not been committed? This option number C. A finds a ring on the roadside. He takes the ring and keeps the same with himself. Question number 61. Which of the following statements are in contravention to the provisions of the Central Vigilance Commission Act 2003? So here the correct option is option number 2, 3 and 4. This is at the time of appointment the Central Vigilance Commission was an accused in a criminal case. So this is very relevant for your current exam because Central Vigilance Commission is one of the most important act and for sure the question will be asked from this act. So at the time of appointment the Central Vigilance Commission was an accused in a criminal case. 3. The central government suo motu made certain rules governing disciplinary matters relating to persons appointed to union public services. And 4. Contrary to the wishes of the Central Vigilance Commissioner, the Vigilance Commissioners took decisions on certain issues. Question number 62. In which one of the following cases there can be no joint sitting of Parliament? This is option number D. When both Houses of Parliament disagree to certain amendments in a bill. Question number 63. Which among the following conveys deed is not required to incorporate the essential components of deed enshrined in it? This is option number A, will. So in the case of will, not the essentials of conveyance or deed hasn't to be followed. It also can be in the writing, handwriting of the person who wants to make the will. 64. With regard to UBDM FID, which of the following statement is or are correct? 1, 2 and 3. It falls within a class of cases which require absolute faith. 2. Every contract is a contract UBDM FID. And 3. A contract of insurance of an example of UBDM FID. 65. X, a 14-year-old boy, was taken by Y from his school on the false pretext of showing him a movie. X was taken to a dark room and confined there. Z took out the boy from there and demanded ransom from the parents of X for the safe return of the boy. Z is guilty of which offense? This is option number 3. Option number 3, extortion. Just a second. This is option number 1 and 2, abduction and kidnapping and also extortion. Option number 1, 2 and 3. The correct option would be not option number 3, only extortion. The correct option would be option number 1, 2 and 3, abduction, kidnapping and extortion. Hmm. 66. A person beginning with notwithstanding anything contained in this act or in some particular provisions in the act or in some particular acts or in any law for the timing in force is sometimes appended to a section in the beginning with a view to give the enacting part of the section in case of conflict an overriding effect over the provision or act mentioned in that clause. Such a clause is called non-obstante clause. You may have read in certain sections when the para starts from notwithstanding, so that notwithstanding is only known as non-obstante, and it has the effect of overriding the provisions of the other clause. Question number 67, consider the following statements. Which of these statements given above are correct? This one and two only. An ordinance can be promulgated by the President of India when the House of the People is dissolved. This is correct. And two, an ordinance can be promulgated by the Governor to impose reasonable restrictions on the freedoms guaranteed under Article 19 of the Constitution. 68, which among the following statements regarding filing rejoinder reapplication in a suit as per CPC 1908 are correct? This option 2 and 3 and 4. Provision of filing rejoinder application is contained under Order 8 of the CPC. This is 2. 3. Rejoinder application may be filed only after due permission of the court. This is also 2 and 4. Rejoinder application is a part of pleading. 69. Which one among the following statement is not correct? This is option number B. The principles of natural justice need not be followed when large number of persons are involved. 70. Ordinarily, an amendment of pleading in a suit may be carried out by the contesting parties under Order 6, Rule 17 of the CPC 1908. The court may allow the amendment. So, in this case, the court may allow the amendment in option number 2 and 3. Let us read. At any stage of the suit and without imposing cost. Question number 71. Which of the following statements are correct? This option number 4. The Indian territory cannot be ceded to any foreign country. So this option number B, option number 4. Question number 72. A function can be characterized as a quasi-judicial when there is a lease inter partes and an authority other than a court is required to adjudicate upon the lease. Question number 73. Z instigated her husband wife to kill the king as her husband would then be declared as the next king. While the king was asleep, Y stabbed him with a dagger but rushed out without pulling out the dagger from his chest. At this point, Z went into the king's chamber and helped her husband in pulling out the dagger. It may be noted that the chloroform was administered to the king's subjects who were guarding him. However, on seeing blood, Z went into a mental condition by which she started sleepwalking every night, uttering the words, "All the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand." In this case Z would be option number C, convicted, as she was not of unsound mind at the time of commission of the offense and hence cannot claim the plea of insanity. 74. Regarding taxing statutes, a well established rule is, if the person sought to be taxed comes within the letter of the law, he must be taxed, however great the hardship may appear to the judicial mind to be. On the other hand, if the crown seeking to recover the tax cannot bring the subject within the letter of the law, the subject is free. However, apparently within the spirit of law, the case might otherwise appear to be. Such a construction is known as, strict construction, option number A. 75. Which among the following are covered within the arbitration agreement as per section 7 of the Arbitration Act? These option number 2, 3 and 4. Let us read for knowledge sake. It may be in the form of a separate agreement. For 3, agreement by parties to submit the dispute which have arisen. This is 2. And 4, agreement by parties to submit the disputes which may arise. Question number 76. According to the Indian Evidence Act 1872, information received from an accused person by a police officer is relevant if option number C, a fact is discovered in consequence of it. 77. A wants to file a complaint under Consumer Protection Act 1986. B, for selling defective car worth rupees 19 lakhs. Where should A file the complaint? This is option number B. District Consumer Dispute Redressal Forum, where B resides or works for gain. So let me tell you the pecuniary jurisdiction of all the three courts. District court has the power to deal a subject matter of value not exceeding 20 lakhs. If the subject matter of the subject matter of the property exceeds 20 lakh but not exceeding 1 lakh, then State Redressal Commission will have the jurisdiction, and over 1 crore worth of subject matter, National Consumer Forum will have the jurisdiction to adjudicate over it. Question number 78. The decisions interpreting section 20C of the Code of Civil Procedure have been held to apply interpreting Article 226 Clause 2 of the Constitution of India for deciding the place or places where the cause of action wholly or in part arises. For entertainment of a writ petition in the High Court, for challenging a central act as being ultra-virus. Such legislative provisions can be called as statutes in pari materia on the same cause. 79. A, B, C, D and E entered the house of a prosperous businessman at 12:30 a.m. breaking open the kitchen door, having planned to rope. They administer chloroform to the middle-aged couple while A, B, C and D managed to find money and gold ornaments in one of the cupboards. He went up to the first floor to look for more cupboards. When he entered the bedroom upstairs, he found a beautiful girl fast asleep. After administering chloroform, he raped her and then rushed downstairs, not venturing to steal anything. However, while leaving the gate, all the five were caught by the police. Which one among the following is the correct propositions of law? This option number D. A, B, C, D and E should be convicted for housebreaking by night, criminal trespass and dacoity, raid with section 34 IPC, but only E should be convicted for rape. 80. The protection under Article 311 Clause 2 of the Constitution of India for giving reasonable opportunity is not available where? This option number C. In the interest of security of state, it is not expedient to give such an opportunity. 81. Which one among the following is not a fundamental rule of pleadings? This option number B. Among the facts, all the facts ought to be pleaded. So this is not the fundamental of the pleadings. 82. Which one among the following statements relating to the state of Jammu and Kashmir is not correct? This option number D. The directive principle of state policy do not apply to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. This is not correct. 83. The term material factors used in the law of pleadings generally refers to this option number 2 and 4. Facta provenda and fact in issue. 84. An unpaid seller has a right of all such which has been given in the options of lien, of stoppage in transit, of resale under certain circumstances and to use. 85. Which among the following statement is and are correct with respect to arbitral proceedings? You may read the same by pausing this video. 86. Find out the correct statement. So this option number C. No one can be compelled to undergo bail mapping test. So it is actually against the rule of self-incrimination. 87. In a civil suit, in case the sole defendant doesn't file the written statement within the stipulated time as per order 8 of the CPC and the delay in the filing of the written statement is not condoned, the court shall option number B, proceed ex parte against the defendant. 88. Finder of a lost thing which is commonly the subject of sale may sell it when the lawful maintenance charges of the finder in respect of the thing found amount to this option number 2, 2/3 of the value. 89. Which one of the following statement is not correct? This option number B. The president is always not bound to act according to the advice of the Union Council of Ministers. 90. In which one of the following cases the writ of mandamus cannot be issued? This option number A. To a corporation for acting contrary to its memorandum of association. 91. A regulation made by the Air India, a statutory corporation, provided that the service of an air hostess can be terminated by giving her 1 month notice or salary in lieu thereof. An air hostess could resign from her job by giving 1 month notice or paying salary of 1 month in lieu of notice. The regulation is unconstitutional because option number it is violative of Article 311 Clause 2 because that air hostess is not given a reasonable opportunity of being heard before her job gets terminated. Question number 92. The Commission of Enquiry Act 1952 doesn't contain which one of the following provision? This is protection of any process relating to manufacturing of goods. So it doesn't contain only this provision and all the other provisions has been given, like mandatory provision for referring a matter to a Commission of Enquiry on the basis of a resolution passed by the state legislature. Then right of cross-examination and legal representation to a person who is called upon to appear before the Commission of Enquiry in any capacity. Then C. Prescribe any time limit for accepting the report of the Commission of Enquiry. 93. In camera trial refers to option number C. Trial to which public and press are not allowed. 94. Which one among the following is the correct legal proposition? This is option number D. Stranger to contract cannot sue, but stranger to consideration can sue. This is actually true. 95. Which one among the following is competent to decide the objection on the mode of appointment of the arbitrator? This option number C. Chief Justice of the concerned High Court. 96. According to the Indian Evidence Act 1872, statement made by a person as to the cause of his death will become dying declaration of even option number even though he was not under the expectation of a death. 97X was a qualified voter at the parliamentary election, but why a returning officer wrongfully refused to take X's vote? No loss was suffered by such refusal because the candidate for whom he wanted to vote had won. Which one among the following is correct statement of law? This option number B, authority held liable on injuria sine damnum principle. 98. The President of India is bound by the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. In which one of the following cases this rule doesn't apply? This option number B, in deciding the age of a judge of the High Court. 99. The rule of construction, nociter a sauces, implies its option number associated words take their meaning from one another. 100. In the morning walk, A saw a dead body lying unattended in the bushes. A removed the gold ring and chain from the body and left the place. What offense has been committed by this option number C? Dishonest misappropriation of property. So this is the end of the session. I have done all the 100 questions, and this session I know has gone a little lengthy because the questions are actually lengthy in nature. So make sure to subscribe to the channel, value my efforts, because I do a lot of hard work in presenting these videos before you. I also cross check the answers whether it is true or not, because even in the answer kits many answers of the questions are given wrong. So kindly people, subscribe, share this channel to the millions, make it to at least 10,000 subscriber base. And I am posting a new video every day. I will be posting such practice papers in the future again. So with this note, I am signing off. Have a great day.